I do not want to talk about smart refrigerators, right? We have, God has given us a brain. We can open the door and see what we need. Wall Street, up, down, sideways. Who knows? Who cares? I don't, you don't either. Nobody knows why it's up or down, right? But everybody wants to talk about it, because if you don't, you don't belong. Let's really talk about the things that matter to you. So, let's talk about some hashtags that we have out there. Let's go Vistex, Vistex customers, you, Vistex footprint, why we exist. Let's talk about that. Customers and prospects come to us and say, what do you folks do? I mean, you guys do so much, you know? If I were to encapsulate all that in one picture, this is it. This is it. We power your go-to-market programs based on five pillars, all the way from master data to how do you price what you buy and sell, how do you drive revenue, and more importantly, how do you drive behavior? So we cover the entire spectrum of your go-to-market programs, and there are so many words and phrases out there, such as contracts and promotions and pricing and deals and royalties. We cover it all. All of that under what we call the go-to-market umbrella. And your go-to-market programs, whether they are with your vendors or your customers, that's what we cover. We started out as, we have to be able to support the process. We have to support the process. So when you support the process, the effort is relatively low, and the value is relatively low as well. But then you have to find ways to bring automation into it, where, again, you kind of go up the value curve as well as the effort curve. After you've automated it, you got to have empathy. You got to look at your users and try to get inside their heads a little bit. Say, what is it that they would like the system to do? And that's what we call empathy. That's a step in the journey. Again, it moves up the value scale and the effort scale. And then we have engagement, right? Sometimes it's just not enough to have empathy with you, right? Because we need to do better than that. We can't just always implement what you ask us to implement. We have to get better. We have to ask better questions. We have to get you to think a little more, right? That's what I call engagement. And we have to do better on that front. And that's been a constant message that I have relayed to my team as well. And I know a few of you have relayed that to me as well. We gotta do better. We cannot just be taskmasters that say, hey, this is how we do it today, so go and figure out how do you do it in Vistex, right? We have to have better engagement. And finally, I believe that the journey, the last stop in the journey, is really experience, right? It also is just not enough to be able to engage. What is the experience that we are delivering to you? I think that's going to be critical. If you look at the consumer side, this is evident, right? Everything that's sold to you for your iPhone apps and your Android apps and everything else on the consumer side, it's all about the experience. And I don't believe that has trickled down yet into the enterprise software space, but it will very, very soon. And the companies that figure that out will be the ones that not only survive, but also thrive. We have Fiori-ized everything. We have Fiori-ized the agreements. So I'm going to show you contextual analytics. We want to provide analytics in the context of an agreement. So here's an agreement. You go into it. Again, it's Fiori-ized, if you will. Only the tabs that matter. So if I go to contract overview, for example, you will see the rules that have been maintained, right? I'm not going to go there because I want to focus more on the analytics. Contextual analytics, of course, this uses our reporting backbone to serve up this data. It's just an umbrella term that we use for reporting, analytics, and modeling. It's just an umbrella term that we use. Just like Fiori is synonymous with UI, for us, WYSI is just synonymous with reporting, analytics, and modeling. We all work with Chatter in Salesforce, Slack for communication, SAP Jam, Google Plus, Facebook. It's a part and parcel of our lives, right? How about if all of these things were to somehow dissolve and morph into what we call VIBES, which is WYSTEX Business Exchange Service, right? So, VIBES, advantage you. What is it? What does it mean? We've tried to take the best of what's out there and try to instill some amount of sanity into it, right? How can we make it more relevant in a business context? How can we help you communicate better with your customers and vendors and partners around your go-to-market programs? So, what is it? It's a portal, but it's not only a portal. It also provides collaboration capabilities. It's not just portal and collaboration. It also provides content. Your partners and your customers also need content about your programs. Why should they sign up for a program with you, right? You want to deliver compelling content to them. And finally, it's also enterprise social. So it's portal, collaboration, content, and social. There is no substitute for human judgment or intuition. There simply isn't, there never will be any substitute for this. So, while we're talking about predictions, I have a few of my own. What are some of my predictions? Here are my predictions. First one, substance will trump show and tell. This applies mainly to the largest software companies out there. Content will trump show and tell. Maybe not this year, maybe not next year. Eventually, substance will trump show and tell. Useful will trump smart. We have a lot of smart things out there, smart bulbs and smartphones and this. They have to be useful. It's more important that they be useful than they be smart. But that's my prediction. Useful will trump smart. And finally, good mental hygiene will trump technology-infused hysteria. Good mental hygiene is a prerequisite for anything and everything we do.